Hello everybody, this is Tavasilan. I'm the Deputy Commissioner of Mon District. We're recording this video in order to create an awareness about the ongoing COVID-19 vaccination program. As I speak, more than 1 crore and 7 lakh people have been vaccinated across the country. More than 20,500 people have been vaccinated in Nagaland, and more than 2,000 people have been vaccinated in Mon District alone. The first thing that we need to understand about COVID is that it's not as benign a disease as we initially thought it to be. As the COVID spread across the globe, researchers and scientists and doctors around the globe have been studying the long-term effects of COVID. The Center for Disease Control in the United States has listed several long-term effects that patients who have contracted COVID are suffering from. The one and the most important is cardiovascular damage, which is inflammation of the heart muscles. Several patients have reported damage to the respiratory system, lung function abnormalities, a phenomenon known as stony lungs. They've been acute kidney injuries in certain patients. Several patients suffer from smell and taste problems. They suffer from rashes, hair loss, psychological depression and anxiety. So COVID is not as simple a disease as we initially thought it to be. There are definitely long-term effects to contracting COVID. The vaccine that's being administered has gone through extensive clinical trials across the globe, and just not in India, but across the globe. Health authorities around the world have approved the vaccine for vaccinating the population only after reviewing the trial data that's been made available and assuring themselves of the safety and efficacy of the vaccine. We'd urge you not to believe in false prophecies surrounding the vaccination program. The Nagaland Baptist Church Council has said that these prophecies are not true and one should not believe, and then avail of the vaccination as and when it's made available to them. Religion does not forbid us from taking the vaccine. I mean, when we're ill, we go to the hospital and we take medicine. So this is just like that. It's just to protect ourselves from COVID-19 that this vaccination program is being carried out. At this juncture, I would like to indicate, several parents who believed in misinformation, rumors and prophecies and did not vaccinate the kids when the time was right. Because of this, several kids have had permanent disabilities, they've had permanent damage, and the parents no amount of regret by the parents right now will help reverse what had happened in the past. So this vaccination is just not about your own safety, but it's also for the safety of your family, your friends, your neighbors, and the community at large. Several people might ask as to why everyone should get vaccinated. The whole reason why people should get vaccinated is that this is the only way the pandemic can end. So either people suffer from COVID and recover, and then their body develops immunity against COVID, or one gets vaccinated and develop immunity against COVID. So that's the only way that the coronavirus will die a natural death, because it will not find a host anymore. So we cannot obviously wait for everyone to contract COVID and develop an immunity. That's the reason why vaccination is being done in the first place. So once we reach a critical amount of population, either they sort of take the vaccine and develop immunity, or they have already contracted COVID and have natural immunity, only then will coronavirus end, because there won't be any more hosts left for the virus to spread. So that's the whole reason as to why it is being recommended that everyone should take the vaccine. And several people might still have this question as to why you're supposed to follow COVID protocols even after being vaccinated. That reason is because once you've taken the vaccine, you are protected against COVID, but then everyone else who has not taken the vaccine is still susceptible to the disease. That is the reason why it's extremely critical for us to keep following COVID protocol, wear masks, maintain social distancing, as well as keep washing or sanitizing your hands from time to time. At this juncture, we also should realize that there's several countries around the world, several people who are vulnerable to COVID, who are waiting for a chance to get the vaccine. I mean, by God's grace, we've been able to manufacture vaccines in our country, and that's the reason why we've all been given the privilege of getting the vaccine much earlier than the rest of the world. So when that's the situation, we should not give up or squander away our chance to get the vaccine and protect ourselves against COVID. There have been people who've always been advocating against vaccines. That's been done in the past, that's happening now, and will also happen in the future. There's been a lot of rumors, misinformation saying that these vaccines reduce the population or cause infertility. It's up to us to separate fact from fiction and do whatever is necessary to keep not only ourselves, but also our families and communities safe. So we'd urge you to please take the vaccine when your turn is up and help our country beat COVID. Thank you so much. God bless us all.